Anyone? The loud yes? Yes.
I really like this place. This place is just that I
No. I want feedback. Honest. Everyone
yeah,
likes
yeah,
the place.
Yeah, yeah. It's an honest. Yeah, it's honest. I'm dead honest. I like this place. I really... the image of college I had when I was just a kid, like, it's just the same. I've lived... You guys really lived up to my expectation, and I hope I can reciprocate it.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. And I appreciate. And at the same time, I can assure you that... whatever dreams you had in your childhood days of a college, or when you were in the last year of your school, the dream of a college, you will definitely get that dream fulfilled. Anyone else? Feedback? Something which you didn't like? Come on. Just now you have heard. You must express yourself. And I'll tell you that while sitting at the courtyard, you can see there are three notice boards there. Pin boards are there. Those are not for the university, those are for the students. And you know what are the names of those boards? The name is Anubhuti. What is Anubhuti in English? Come on. What is Anubhuti? Feelings. Then the second name is Abhivyakti. What is the Abhivyakti? Very soon, maybe by evening, you will have those names on above that notice boards, those pin boards. But what is Abhivyakti? Yes? What do you call Abhivyakti in English? No, not personality. Expression. I got the word from here only. Expression. So that is the freedom you have. That is the amount of freedom you have when you are in this campus. You have the freedom to express yourself. Whether it is exceptional, as he said, or whether it is even negative if you have. So when I'm talking about the rules and regulation, I'll first introduce myself. Name is Ajay Yadav, and I'm the registrar of the university. Apart from handling the administrative responsibilities, I also teach subjects like finance and general management. So those people in the School of Business, they will be seeing me in class also. But yeah, rest assured, everyone will see me in the campus. So when we talk about regulations, these regulations are not the regulations which we are enforcing on students. Because we believe in the principle of integral education, where self-discipline is far more important than the discipline being enforced. But yes, there are certain guidelines which the government has issued from time to time, and which we need to follow to keep this place a place of your dream, to maintain the dignity of the institution. There are certain things which we follow. All right, so my first question, it's a long presentation, so I'll not get into the presentation mode. I'll just have some question and answer, and we will cover up everything. So my first question, what is the timing of the university? Anyone? Come on, loud. All right, I think you are a little wrong on this. Yeah. Yes. There are two slots of timings in the university. One is from 7:30 to 2, 1:30 to 2, and the second is from 10 to 4. So there will be some classes, and I think the admission office must have informed you while you were taking your admissions. There will be some classes which will be held during the morning hours, and there will be some classes in the afternoon hours. So you need to check your timetable well, especially I think the classes for business school, first year BBA, will be from 7:30 onwards. Two sections. We get into the third section, that will be from 10 to 4. So those who do not want to get up early in the morning and want to have a long sleep, they can come at 10. And those who want to get free early, they need to come at 7:30. So 7:30 means that you start from your home at 6:30. All right? So it doesn't mean that you start from your home at 7:30 to come to college. All right, the second thing. What is the mode of communication which we follow in the university? Anyone? What is the mode of communication you follow in your daily life? All official communications, how do you do that? Through mails. We don't write postcards now, eh? We don't write letters now, we just send mails. All of you either must have got the email IDs of yours, or you will get your email IDs and passwords very soon. And please check your email on a day-to-day basis, because all university correspondence will be through the emails. And if this happens quite often, especially when you are paying your fee and you don't pay on time and there is a fine imposed on it, then you say that I didn't get the mail. All mails are sent and received by everyone. We are assured of this. And in case you are not getting the mails, please respond immediately and contact the help desk in the IT department and make sure that you start receiving the mails. All notifications related to assessments will be coming on email IDs. All notifications related to the uploading of study material will be through email ID. So make sure you check your emails on a day-to-day basis. Or in fact, on a smartphone, you can have the notifications so that you don't have to open all the time. You just see the notification and you are sure that this mail is for me, so I need to read it. So these are the two most important things which everyone has to keep in mind. That is timings and communication. When you're communicating with any department, your communication must be through email IDs. We don't expect you to write letters and applications. If you don't write an email and come to my office, I'll certainly say that, give me an application. But the preference is that you write the application through email. Now the third most important thing. What is that? What is the third most important thing in your life in a university? Discipline? Today morning, Govind Kaka gave a long speech, and in his speech there was a message. What was that message? How many of you attended that session? Yeah, good. So I have the same lot. So what was the message? Yes, anyone? Yeah. You should be humble. Good. Any other message? Yes, that is very important. And respect doesn't mean that there has to be some categorization of age and anything. Respect is to be for everyone and of the same degree, irrespective of his or her age. All right? So your friends should be respected in the same manner as you are respecting your elders. Even at home, your younger brothers and sisters must be respected in the same way. Because, as he said, you get what you give. Then the most important thing, he said that, don't feel shy and don't cross the boundaries. All right, there is a boundary for everything. So this is a suggestion, not an instruction. And because this is important not just for your life at Auro, but even for life outside Auro. As I said yesterday also, because these are the years which will either make you, and I'm confident they will never break you. So make sure that you use this time of your life to create a path for yourself. Just now the previous speaker, Mr. Darshan Sedani, also talked about the same thing. That is, you must have a vision. So don't feel shy of asking for things. If you feel there is something wrong happening, not only with you, with anyone in this university, please feel free to contact. And whom to contact? The first point of contact for anyone and everyone will be your respective school heads. All right? So if you are from School of Business, Dr. Monica Suri becomes the first point of contact. If you're in School of IT, Dr. Sharad Raghuvansh becomes the first point of contact. Similarly, for other schools, you have the head of schools. So they become your first point of contact when you are in trouble or you see someone in trouble. The second point of contact will be, for all academic matters, Dr. Rohit Singh, the Dean of Academics. So if you don't get your issues sorted out with your head of school, then the second point of contact becomes Dr. Rohit Singh for all academic matters. And for all administrative matters, I am the point of contact. So you need to contact the registrar. And where do you find the registrar? Registrar sits just next to the program office. And the office of Dean Academics is located in the first building on the top floor at the right end of the building. There are nameplates on all the floors, so you can easily identify where the person sits. All right? So don't be shy of raising questions, raising doubts, and raising issues. But yes, the second point is equally important. You must follow the boundaries. Don't create troubles for others so that the trouble doesn't get created for you. So this is a suggestion which I would like to make. So we'll just run through. This is what I was talking about. It starts with a word of caution. There is nothing threatening. You are starting a new journey of your life. Enjoy as much as possible. But keep in mind that your enjoyment should not affect enjoyment of others. Think big. You must have dreams. And your dreams can only be accomplished if you are disciplined. So these are the few words of caution. This is the most important thing. And when you move around the campus, you'll find that at different places, there's a board which says, this campus is a ragging-free campus. Ragging is strictly prohibited. And anyone involved in ragging, directly or indirectly. And what I'm going to say now is not what I want to say, but this is what the law of the land says, that anyone involved in ragging will be penalized as per the directions of the Supreme Court. Because ragging is a offense. So don't get involved in it and don't let others get into it. As soon as you see something of this sort being happening at any place in the campus, please report the matter immediately either to my office or to the dean's office. All right? So we want everyone to enjoy their life as much as possible, but within that boundary. So this ragging falls outside that boundary, so don't get into it. I have already talked about. The second one is your VLE, Dean Academics, Dr. Rohit Singh will talk about this. Your working days are from Monday to Friday, all right? But on Saturdays, if during the weekdays, there is a holiday, the classes will be scheduled on Saturdays. So Monday to Friday on a regular basis, but occasionally you will have classes on Saturdays also. These are the regular timings of the university when you can find all the staff members, everyone in the office. But as I said, for BBA first year, the classes start from 7:30 to 1:30. And the buses leave at around 2. Whereas for others, the classes will start from 10 and will end at 4. I must mention here that in case you have any office work, the offices are working even on Saturdays from 9:30 to 5:30. So for all academic transactions, they take place from Monday to Friday, but administrative transactions will happen from Monday to Saturday. This is the code of conduct, and I don't need to get into all these things. Why? Because I believe you all are now sensible enough and you understand that what is the code of conduct, how to behave in life. This campus, you must have gone around, though it's rainy season, but still you can find that it's absolutely clean. The corridors, rooms, library, wherever you go, it is absolutely clean. And we expect that you will help us in maintaining this cleanliness. We have a huge team of housekeeping staff. They work from 8 till 6 to keep this campus clean. But without your cooperation, this cannot be achieved. So please ensure that you maintain cleanliness, you support them in their effort of making this campus a clean campus, as well as you must have seen that this is a very green campus also. You will be tempted to pluck flowers, but please avoid it, because it looks beautiful there, all right? So leave things where they look beautiful. This property belongs to you. So as an owner of the property, the way you maintain your house, maintain this also. And in case you fail, then we will have to maintain. So just avoid getting into administrative problems. You must have seen that on the courtyard, just opposite to the courtyard, there is a staircase, and on the staircase there is a notice board. Just next to the notice board, there is a board which says the Committee for Student Grievance Redressal. So in case you have any issues related to any of the academic or non-academic matters, you can contact the committee and they will help you resolve those issues. All right? So the Student Grievance Redressal team is there, and they are there to help you out. Complaint procedure I have already talked about. That is, you have to first contact your head of the department, then Dean Academics for academic matters, and me for all administrative matters. All right? I hope I have made things clear and I have made your life easier. Feel confident and feel as if you are at home. All right? Be comfortable and enjoy your life at university. Welcome to Auro University. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I'd like to request Mr. Kumar Kaushik, sir, to discuss about the examination pattern and all, assessments pattern.
Good afternoon, everyone. Bear with me. I have a sore throat, so just bear with me. Examination department is a department where your all studies are evaluated. how you have performed in subjects, we generally keep the record of that, right? There are some rules and regulation for examination which you need to know. Apart from that, after my session, my dean, Dean Academics, Dr. Rohit Singh, will give you some insight about the online portal, which we call it VLE, Virtual Learning Environment, where you have to interact on everyday basis. And at the same time, it is always related, connected with the examination result, your attendance, your evaluations, assessments. So every module, if I'm saying module, you take it as a subject, right? Every subject has a lot of assessments. Some are 10%, some are 5%. There will be midterm, there will be end-term examinations. Every student has to go through all the assessments, and after calculating the marks which you have obtained, you will be declared promoted for the next semester. So just go through, have a look of some of the regulations. What we call programs. Suppose you have been enrolled in BBA program. Program, we have discussed. So program, generally your school or your subject or your class in which you have been enrolled. Like BBA is a program, right? Then there are course / module. As I told you, when we talk about the course or module, it is the subject which you are going to study. There will be, then we have a core course. Core courses are those courses which you need to pass. These are the mandatory subjects which you have to take it and you have to clear it. Then there will be elective course. Elective course generally will come in the last semester. And it is the it will be choice based. I mean, you can opt for elective courses. We will give you the alternatives in which you have to select your preferred course. Right? There will be a called term. A term is a semester. It's a semester means it will be a 18 weeks course. 18 weeks, 5 days a week. Okay? Then there will be evaluation. As I told you, in every subject, every module, there will be a criteria to assess you, how you have performed in that particular module. That will be assessed by your respective module leaders. Now, the second thing. Here in Auro, we used to give 3 attempts to every student to clear this subject. First, there will be an end term. By chance, if you couldn't clear it, then there will be a receipt, first receipt. If you clear it, then you will be promoted. If not, then again you have to go for the second receipt. And if you clear it, you will be promoted. And God forbid, if you couldn't clear it, then you will go for the module repeat. Module repeat means you will be a year back. Please go through the last minimum attendance criteria. Please understand and keep it in your mind that 80% attendance is must to appear for the end-term examination. If you couldn't get that 80% attendance, you will be in trouble. Okay? Got it? Okay. Acha. Every module has been given some weightage. We call it credit. It's a 4 credits, 2 credits, right? So we call it credits. So a credit is defined by 60 contact hours. Similarly, after clearing one particular semester, you will be given grade point. Grade point is basically the calculation or the average of all the credit, all the grades you got in that particular modules. It is the average of that. Then similarly, if you pass one semester, there will be a grade point. When you clear it second semester, it will be cumulative grade points. So it will be the average of two semesters, right? The internal assessment marks are awarded and notified to all the students, right, through virtual learning environment, which you will know shortly. It will be uploaded on that VLE, and you can access from there. You don't need to come to the examination office and find out what is my marks. No. You can access your account, and you will get it. Probably you must have got the email ID account or something. Really, you got it? Okay. There is in the process of assessments, there will be assessment deadlines will be given by the module leader, which you need to adhere. Failing which, either there will be a marks reduction or completely marked zero about that. We are very clear into that. There is a late submission rule. If you're late by one day, or there will be a maximum marks 40% within two working. If you're late within 2 working days, it will be 40% marks. So and so forth. Non-submission of the coursework or non-appearance in the examination in the first attempt, you will be awarded zero for that. I'll tell you, here in Auro University, now we follow 10 credits, 10 point scale. What is 10 point scale? I'll let you know. This is the new grade points which we have started from 2017. Here, if you go through that, in the left side, it's a letter grade, and it's a range of the marks given, and the grade points are given after that. So if anybody who's got the in their mark sheet, if it is mentioned O, it means outstanding, and his marks must be in between greater than 90% and between 90% or and 100. Okay, his marks will be between that only. So go through that. It's very important for you that you should maintain your score and get the higher grade for that. Because this 10 grade points is acceptable across all India, even in the other countries as well. So it is universally accepted grade points. Anything else? I'll suggest you, and at the same time, I caution you, everyone, study well. And at the same time, I have given only one side of the examination. There are a lot of punishments if you found some other activities. So do well, study well, and we are here to help you out. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. The next session is about VLE and MSS. I'd like to call Dr. Rohit Singh, Dean Academics, to explain you about the VLE and MSS.
A very good afternoon. He's standing in between you and lunch, I understand. So you have to be here for 5-10 minutes, and then I will quickly wrap it up before actually I show you what is there in the VLE and MSS. So have you settled down in Auro University now?
Yes, sir.
Second day. Feeling comfortable or not? That anxiety of being fresher at the university has gone or still with you? Have you sunk in the feeling that now you are at Auro? No, yes. Okay, whatever the people before me, they told you, you know, they were telling you because we are a very fine university. And what I mean by fine university is we have certain rules and regulation with us. And if you don't follow that rule and regulation, then we implement fine, impose fine. So both fine university and if do not adhere to the rule and regulation, we will have certain fine implication to it. What you need to follow is there are certain basic rules, regulations, guidelines which has been given to you. You simply have to follow that. Now the problem with the student coming from class 12 to the graduation is, anyone? You start developing wings, you know, and you feel that now I'm in university, I have to fly. So what I would request you fly as high as you can, like eagle, you know, but you have your eyes should be on the ground, and ground here means the Auro University. So, and when you fly too fast and too high, then you leave everything behind, and there comes the Auro University, which is very fine university, you know. So what I'm going to show you is we have certain online portals with us. We have VLE, we call it virtual learning environment, which is, I hope everyone in their orientation kit, you must be have been given with a particular login ID, you know. Have you tried login into it? Okay. Please do it, because it is a possibility you took an admission into BBA and you are being reflected into BBA LLB, you know. So we have to make a correction into it. So if you don't check it, I will assume everything is fine. Okay. So please log on to it. You will get certain information. The first thing which I'm going to explain you is the virtual learning environment. You know, before you log in over there, if you see on the left hand side, it's Auro University, you know, link is given. Okay. The Auro University is given, then NIMS is given. LMS is Learning Management System. We have an HRM, you know, Human Resource Management System with us. And there are other links given to it. What you need to follow is, at this point of time, you have to log in with your particular login ID. So I'm logging from my email ID just to help you understand what we normally do. All the faculty members at the university follow this pattern. And what will happen if you bunk the class? How you will get notes and everything? What will happen if you are not well for 1 week, you submit a medical certificate to Kaushik sir. Sir, I was absent on these days because I'm unfit to attend the classes. Every instruction which is being given in the class by each individual faculty member, that will be uploaded over here, you know. So once you log in, this is the dashboard homepage, you will get into it, you know, and these are the things over here. So your profile. So suppose if you click onto the profile, your profile will come. This is for, you know, for us taken care of, you know. So everything is given over here. Purposefully, I have not filled too many informations, you know. So, but you can come in touch with me and you'll get every other information. The most important part is membership, schedule, resources, announcement, you know. I as a teacher, teaching anything into a class, upload all my PPT, notes, case studies, any learning thing which is required by you in the class, before the class or after the class, it goes into resources part. Okay. So suppose I am teaching to a group of students in BBA or MBA, you know, and I am taking a class, consumer behavior, which now Monica ma'am used to teach, you know. So, and I have to let you know what is the module handbook which is given over there. So my module handbook will be here. What is module handbook? It's a Bible for you for each respective subject. Okay. What is specified in the module handbook? How many weeks I am going to teach you? In each week, what are my topics? In each topic, what I'm going to teach with subtopic? Is there any assessment? Is there any reading? Is there any submission which you have to make? So if I come in the fourth week and say, today we have test, and somebody says, sir, where is test? We are not aware about it. I will say, boss, please go to VLE. Clear? So each one of you sitting in this room
has to go through their respective module handbook. It is approximately prepared by each faculty member to the length of 15 to 20 pages. Clear? So five subjects, 100 pages, you have to read before you go. And week one, you know, I have a class. So before class, after the class, whatever I have taught, it will be uploaded over here. Clear? So you will find all lecture weeks over here. So if you miss third week, you will get notes from here. So don't say, sir, I don't have notes, therefore I can't give examination. Sorry, available on VLE. Okay? Then most important part is sometimes, you know, you have to submit certain assignments. It's given over here, you know. So when you click on assignment, you see here students, you know, I need to create an assignment. There was topic called segmentation and positioning. Assignment wahan pe aa gaya. And you have to submit it. Remember, as Kaushik sir has told you, you will get 2 days, 1 week, whatever is the timeline defined by the faculty member, they will create that assignment on VLE. Meaning, you have to submit a soft copy. If required by a teacher, you will submit a hard copy into the program office. Clear? So you will get a notification. Everybody is having a smartphone. Hopefully, huh? Nahi hoga to padosi ka dekh lena. But whatever it is, huh? So you will get assignment, you will get a message. On that message, it will be defined when you are having that assignment submission. If you submit it, we have a provision. I'm not going into detail. Anyone? Niche segmentation. You see, it is an old one. So it is giving all, you know, last date, accepted until, modified until, kis, kya kya karna, everything is given. So please read these instructions. You have to, so created on this date, open on this date, due on 22nd February, accept until 24th, meaning last date of submission is 24th. If you try to submit on 25th, you will not accept it. It means what you will get? What you will get? I understand. This will happen to you, you know. You will get zero. Huh? So as you are not able to understand what you are going to get, that will happen at the same point of time if you miss the date. So don't then come, sir, and then I am saying very fine university, then you will go to Kaushik, sir. Sir, Rohit sir is not accepting my assignment. Please take this, you know. He will never accept. Because he knows that the assessment date has been created on VLE. A notification also goes to him and he will take into consideration. So we never accept hard copy directly, even if we are doing. You have to submit the hard copy in the program office. Clear? So this is related to the submission of assignment part. So we have another menu called Dropbox, and you will find the name of the students. What will happen if you are not putting anything on assignment part? I would request, okay, you go for a one-page reading, write your write-up, submit into my Dropbox. And see, everybody is, you know, submitting through Dropbox. Why I'm asking for soft copy? Any idea? What we do as a student? Okay, sir has given me assignment today. We go to Google Uncle, enter, get some ready-made masala, put it into my document, submit to my faculty member. Once you submit, I will put it into my software, which is called as Turnitin, and it will tell me, Mr. X has copied from 23 different sites. And these are the details. So I don't need to check itself, you know, it is already there in front of me. What will I give you? You understand now, huh? Good. So this is the usage of Dropbox, which you have to follow. So all your submissions has to go through either assignment or Dropbox, you know. And then there is also an option, you know, where faculty member can announce few things, you know. Go to the announcement list. And what you will see is wing announcement from the past 365 days. So suppose if I need to make an announcement today that on a class of Friday you need to read page number 323, topic so and so, I will do it from here and it will go to your mailbox. Clear? So when I'm coming on next day, I will assume that you all have read. And then we will discuss into the classroom. So this is what VLE is all about. In a very short, I'm letting you know, because it will take a lot of time. I'm not going into the detail, but this is what you will follow. If you go to the Pinkal, go to more. You see the module codes. So suppose if you are into BBA first year, BSc hospitality first year, IT first year, all your modules will come over here. So this is for me, these are the paper I have taught. So whatever you are going to study, 5, 6 module, whatever it is, it will be reflected over here. For whichever module you want, module handbook, details, everything, you will go again, like I have explained you for one of the modules. It's easy or complicated? At the very first instance, understanding looks like complicated, you know. But my request to you, please use that login and password. That will help you to understand what actually this VLE stand for, you know, clear? So this is all from the VLE point of view. I will take you back to the nemesis. So there is a student called Ayushi Agarwal in MBA. Put your name over here, put your photo over here, and it will make you feel good, you know, that okay, now you're part of our university. See all these things. Timetable, attendance, exams, result, feedback, faculty, leave request, exam hall ticket. Who pays your fees? So there are two login IDs. Okay? As we have given you into orientation kit, one to you, same will be sent to your parents also. If you are paying your fees, do let me know. I will not send them email ID, login and everything, you know. What will happen if your father asks you, do you have exam tomorrow? You will say no, suppose. Assuming you will say yes. But if you say no, he will say okay, fine. And suppose if he logged in into Nemesis with his login ID, he will say there is an exam tomorrow. And by that time, next morning, when you were trying to come to Auro University, you went straight to Dumas. You took a right turn from TGB. And when you went back in the evening, your father asked, how was the exam? No, there was no exam. Fine. These all details pertaining to attendance, exam, marks will be reflected over here. Clear? Please make it sure that whatever you are telling at home is in sync with Nemesis. Clear? So, and just see the attendance, you know, subject is given, attendance is given. And see the beauty. If you say, sir, I was ill on so and so date, you know, and please take my medical during the examination all, what will happen? Kaushik sir will check the data through examination of attendance from Nemesis. So we have a date-wise attendance also, okay? Just for our information. So, and this is for your information also. So we will have everything over here. It will also tell which class you are there. Morning class, afternoon class, post-lunch, pre-lunch. It will reflect everything. So this is a call. We prepare a sheet for you on a ready-made basis for my students, you know. Is that clear? So I'm not going into the detail. This is all. And result, just 1 minute, you know. This is what your father and mother will be able to see, you know. Clear? So everything is here. I don't want to further stand in between you and lunch, but if you have any question, please feel free to ask. We have library after this? Just now? Any questions? Any question you have? No? Very fine class, huh? Yes. Okay, there are 3 important offices you have to be in touch with. One is the program office, which will issue all these login ID, password, any requisites which you have. Second is the examination office, which will start coming into the 4th week of usage. Jab se exam shuru hoga. And third is related to any other academic matter, you need to come to your respective heads. And these 3 places you have to visit on and off in order for any issues. Clear? From this year, what we are going to start is 2 new things. I will come later on into your class and explain you. One is a choice-based credit system. We will offer a basket of at least 9 to 10 courses. At your will, you have to select 1 or 2, whatever you want to do. Clear? So if you are studying in BBA, you can take a subject of hospitality also. If you are studying in IT, you can take a paper of BBA also. If you are in liberal arts, you can study a paper into management also. So that will come, I will come to your class, explain you what is happening over there, and then you can choose and pick. Last thing is, we have started using a partial smart classroom facility, which we call it lecture capture. So there are specific 5 classrooms with us, where when you are going to study, going to learn something, lecture will be automatically captured over here. The moment the schedule is over, it will automatically be linked through VLE and other sources. So now onwards from this session, we are also going to give you classroom discussion session on a video on VLE. Is that clear? Last opportunity. Any question? If you will not ask anything, I will assume you landed up into a fine university and my batch is very fine, you know. Anything? Thank you so much. I would invite Vittal sir, you know, to give the details of the library.
He is going to tell us about rules and regulations of the library.
Thank you, madam. Good afternoon. Say loudly, I know you are hungry. I am the person between the you and the lunch, right? Don't curse me for that. Okay? So the first slide says you, the only thing absolutely you have to know is the location of the library. I hope everybody knows the library place. The first day you landed in the Auro University and the first leg was in the library, right? So you know the location of the library. Now welcome to the library. I am not going to tell more about the rules and regulation of the library, but I use the word etiquettes, library etiquettes. So I'm a bit softer and telling the rules and regulations of the library. We do follow the rules and regulations of the library, but I prefer to use the word etiquettes, right? Library is the heart of the university. This Auro University library is entirely different from the other university libraries in the sense it's a hub of all academic activities. How many of you I have an interest in debates and the book reading parts. Most of the people. So we have every, in the library for everybody, there is something is stored in the library. And every Thursday we have one activity in the library like book reading activity. So anybody can come forward and take a part in that activity and you can talk on any book, whatever, whichever you're interested to you. Whether it is fiction or ethics or history, any book which had an impact on your life also. So that is a one different activity in the library we have. So these are the team. We have a very small team in the library. So everybody is helpful. So anybody needs in the library requirements, you can approach these people. So Tushar Rana is the assistant librarian at that side. Pramod and this side, Ilai Kumar. So these are the people who can help in the library for you for searching the books, articles, anything. This is a schematic depiction and you know that how the library things are arranged inside the library. Where is the reading room, where is the sitting part area and the digital area part and the private discussion rooms, etc. That I'll show that. So this is what I'm telling that library etiquettes. Emily Post, anybody knows about the Emily Post? Anybody? She is a synonymous of etiquettes in the America. So she wrote many books on the etiquettes in the North American countries. So simple things in simple words, whenever you enter into the library, please walk quietly. because the library is a place of quietness. Most of the people are reading inside the library. And you use the voice also very quietly, just like me, because I need this kind of a mic, because last 20 years I'm using in the library. That is why I'm using this kind of a microphones, right? So you also whisper in the library whenever you need something with the library staff, not in a louder voice, right? Turn off your mobile phones whenever you enter into the library, or either keep in a vibration mode. Whenever you get the call, emergency, you can attend the call, but outside the library, right? And whenever you enter into the library, please establish your identity card to the library staff so that they can issue the books and journals, whatever you need. And there is a register kept in the on the desk of the issue counter, where you can enter your name and signature and your class. That is for must for everybody whoever enter into the library. In the library, the foods and drinks are not allowed inside the library, so we have to maintain the cleanness in the library. Why we are discouraging the food and drinks in the library, you know that attracts the rodents. Once rodents enter into the library, then the library will go destroyed, right? That is why we discourage the foods and drinks inside the library. So what we have in the library? We have in the library around 12,000 books in the library, physical books. But we have over 170,000 e-books also there. So library is a very, very much, very rich in the collection in terms of the books and e-books. And print journals, we have physical journals. So print journals in the sense physically whatever available in the library, that is 136 journal we have. And electronic journal, look at the figure, 16,304 journals we have in the library. And there are business cases like 12,000 we have, and e-newspapers, you have access to over 1,267 newspapers also you can access from this library. Apart from that, we have these electronic databases like ProQuest, EBSCO, JSTOR for the business management students, and for the EBSCO for the hospitality students, and REST, Manupatra, Taxman, Haina Online, and other databases for the law students. And humanities also accessible from the ProQuest and the EBSCO. There are some articles on that humanities in JSTOR also. Apart from that, we have a company databases like Capital Line Plus for the management students, Ace Equity, Ace Mutual Funds, Ace Knowledge Portal. These are the company databases, especially useful for the BBA students, law students, and MBA students. Right? The best part of this library is the library is accessible inside the campus and outside the campus. You can access this library from anywhere in the world through web. And there are also 10 computers inside the library to access your databases whenever you are inside the library. This can be accessible from your smartphones also, right? Then how to search the books when you enter into the library, how to search the books. We have an online public access catalog, which is available on the library website also, and you can also access that opaque from your smartphones also. And every book has a defined number, which is a classification number, we say that, which locates in a particular space on the stack, shelf, you can say that. We will help the how to locate the library physically, that the library staff will help you, right? Am I clear? Right? And borrowing books. Identity card is a very much necessary for anyone to borrow the books from the library. So the first and foremost is you must carry the identity card whenever you enter into the library. And whenever you issue the book, we will give you a receipt also, which says that what is the due date of that particular book, so that you can return the books within the due date in order to avoid the fines, right? How many books? For undergrad students, you have three books can be issued for 15 days. For the postgraduate students, for the four books for the 15 days again. apart from the books issuing journals and all, so we have a library training programs also. I may take some sessions on the citations management for the final year students, second year students, and also I am also going to take some sessions on the plagiarism also, right? And then how to search your databases also very important, because the searching the databases, searching on the Google is not similar. They are entirely different. You need some skills for the searching the databases, which I am going to take a sessions on that in your classroom, or after library hours also we can be helpful on that. This is all for my side. If you have any questions, you can also ask a question. These are some snapshots from the lenses. This is a library entrance. This is the library desk room, issue desk. And this is the library stack room. Again, stack room. This is the lobby area. And this is the private discussions rooms. You can also use rooms. And this is the reading area. Again, a reading area. And this is a digital area where the computers are placed for access to library databases. Thank you for your patience. Any questions, please do. Thank you. Time to finish.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. There is a small announcement, a change in the venue. Those who were to assemble in C234 Dramatics